They say university makes students, here students make university. So with the slogan of Think Big, I, Himanshu Kaushik, your host of the day, would like to welcome you all in today's webinar on residential facilities at LPU. And I hope that you all are doing fine, sound and happy at wherever you're taking this webinar from. So before we know a lot more about the facilities that LPU has to provide to our students, we have our expert with us today. So I shall introduce you to our expert. We have Mr. Ravi Kant Patak, sir, an assistant professor and deputy dean, Division of Residential Services, Lovely Professional University, here with us. An accomplished academician and administrator with over 14 years of experience in the education sector, Mr. Patak has established himself as a seasoned professional in the field. In his current role, Mr. Patak is responsible for overseeing the management of the university's residential facilities, which house thousands of students, and he plays a key role in ensuring that students are provided with a safe and comfortable living environment that fosters academic success and personal growth as well. So, sir, it is a pleasure for us, and I heartily welcome you in the webinar, and so looking forward for the amazing session.
Thank you, Himanshi. And again, I welcome all the listeners to this webinar. And in this webinar, I'll take you through the different facilities and the aspects of residential services, what we call hostels, in Lovely Professional University. So we have in total of 8 boys hostels, including apartments, which house around 18,500 seats for boys. Along with that, we have 7 girls hostels, along with apartments, which house around 6,500 of seats. And this is one of the largest residential facility in one campus in Asia, or you can also say it is in world also. As far as I know, right. So in this hostels and apartments, there are various kind of amenities, various kinds of facilities, and the ambience we provide to students to nurture them as successful academicians, successful entrepreneurs, successful professionals. So let me take you through a tour of this gigantic residential facility. This is one of the sample apartment rooms. And in this, we have various kind of seaters that we provide. This is a two-seater room, two-seater apartment room. And apart from that, we have one-seater, three-seaters, and four-seaters as well in apartments. Similarly, we have standard hostel rooms, again, having various sitting capacities, like one-seater, two-seater, three-seaters, four-seaters, five-seaters, and even six-seaters. In girls' hostels also, we have the same kind of architecture of seaters. And we endeavor to provide a very good ambience for studying in the hostel rooms, where you get very calm and composed environment. There is zero disturbance from outside, so that you can pursue your academics in a better way. So as far as the facilities in the room is concerned, there are certain unique facilities. Apart from that, there are common facilities also. So in the unique facilities, if we talk about apartments, we provide wooden box bed, air conditioner, attached room, attached washroom, geysers, a small kitchenette in one and two seaters specifically, and wooden cupboards. Whereas in standard rooms, we have iron bed, air conditioner or air cooler as per your choice. Attached washroom is there, which is having geyser connection in them. And we provide steel almirah in standard rooms. The common facilities that we provide in the rooms are 24-hour security services, CCTV surveillance, electricity backup, which will be chargeable beyond the free units. So every seater has got a charge, and based on that seater, you get a specific amount of free units, which is not chargeable. So if you consume beyond that free units, then it will be chargeable. Then staff assistance, because all the hostel wardens stay in the same hostel. Medical services, we have a hospital inside the campus itself, where you will get free consultation from specialized doctors, but the medicine and test that they prescribe will be on payment. Then Wi-Fi services there, and free unit electricity units as per the seater that we provide. So there is a very good opportunity that you students have in terms of early decision benefit. If you book the hostel facility before 31st of May, then you will be getting early decision benefit of rupees 10,000 in apartment as well as standard rooms. Apart from that, we have in every hostel, dining facility are available, where there are multiple options of dining, whether it is location, whether it is cuisines, whether it is the type of meal that you want to take. So let me take you through that. So we provide various mess categories. One is standard mess with four meals. Four meals means breakfast, lunch, evening snacks, and dinner. And in that, we provide multiple types of cuisines, exclusively North Indian, South Indian, Rajasthani, Haryanvi, Gujarati, Eastern and Northeastern. And the locations could be different for different cuisines. Similarly, we also provide North and South Indian cuisines combo. And you will get these cuisines in all the four meals. Apart from that, we also provide standard mess with three meals, which will constitute of breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Again, the cuisines will be same as I explained in the four meals. Along with that, we also provide standard mess with two meals. So you have an option to opt for either breakfast and dinner or lunch and dinner, as the case may be. Suppose you are a late riser and you get up late in the morning and directly you want to go to your classes. So you generally miss the breakfast, which we do not recommend. But there are certain students who are in such habit. So for them, we provide two meal options in terms of lunch and dinner. Similarly, if I talk about breakfast and dinner, if the academic block is a bit far from the hostel, then you will sometimes feel that you will not be able to go back to the hostel have lunch, and then come back to the classes again. So for them to facilitate such kind of things, we also provide breakfast and dinner options in standard mess, two meals. Apart from that, we also provide a la carte where you have choices of dishes. It is kind of restaurant type where you can choose the dishes that you want to take. So the rates are different for different types of mess. Along with that, we also provide laundry facility in the hostels where you can provide 70 clothes per month and it will cost you only 5,000 rupees for 10 months or the regular session, which includes the regular exams. We also have indoor gym along with open gym in all the hostels. Indoor gym is at the central location. We have study rooms in all the hostels where suppose you have taken a shared accommodation and your roommates want to sleep, but you want to study. So you can use this facility to study at night. Similarly, for recreation, we have TV rooms. We also try that the students should not waste their time to roam around here and there for daily or regular kind of grooming. So that is why we provide saloon in the hostels itself or in the near vicinity of the hostels. We have one of the largest indoor sports complex inside the campus, which has badminton courts, basketball courts, shooting range, combative sports arena, squash arena, and swimming pool also. And this is the Olympic size swimming pool where you can avail and practice swimming. Not only that, we have also playgrounds attached to all the hostels where you can go and have or enjoy outdoor sports. In the hostel, we provide a safe and secure environment and we only allow authorized persons to go inside the hostel, and that we manage using the turnstile gates. Along with that, we have CCTV camera installed everywhere in the hostels to have a surveillance of the activities that is going on in the hostels. We also have security staff in all the hostels to help you out in various situations if you fall in them. We have firefighting system installed in all the hostels along with the fire tending vehicle also. We also provide departmental store inside the hostel to meet your daily needs. We have post office inside the campus, multiple banks inside the campus. Uni Hospital is there, which is 24/7 active, and we have specialized doctors available in the hospital. We have ambulance also that you can take help of them whenever you feel that you need to go to hospital. And that service is provided 24/7, round the clock. We have Uni Mall where there are multiple joints like departmental stores, clothing joints, food joints, We also have Domino's Pizza inside, which vegetarian pizzas. Because why I'm saying this, because it is the USP of our university that we provide only vegetarian meal. We do not deal with non-vegetarian meals. For non-vegetarian meals, we have a cafe, which we call as food court, which has got a path from the campus, but it is outside the campus. And that is managed by the external vendor. So we have the departmental store in the Unimall. Along with that, from time to time, we organize various activities for students in the hostel, like sports activities, academic activities like book fair, then cultural activities like kite flying or Makar Sankranti or Guru Purav, then painting and Rangoli competitions and things like that. So we try to inculcate the value for all the cultures, and we also try to make such events so that the students remain healthy and fit. So if you consider hostel, then definitely you will be having benefits as compared to PG or rented accommodation, like assured safe and secure environment, hygienic mess plans. You don't have to pay extra for time and money. Then sports and gym facility are at subsidized costs. 500 plus resident staff or faculty are staying inside the campus, from whom you can take academic guidance. There are various activities that take place beyond 5 p.m. that will be accessible for only the hosteler students, like placement activities. Different recreational activities, some interaction sessions with external speakers, etc. The facilities like Unimall, Central Library, hospitals, project and innovation studio, all of them can be availed beyond 5 p.m. if you are an hostel. That you will not get if you opt for a PG or rented accommodation. These are some of the testimonials or endorsements that the students have given after staying in the hostel. So that is it. That was a very overview of the hostels that we provide and the facilities that we provide in the hostels. If you have any query, I'm happy to take them.
Sir, thank you so much first for navigating our students through our residential facilities, through the facilities that LPU has to provide to all the students. And thank you so much, sir, for crediting your time, for giving your time for us, for the students as well. And yes, sir, we have certain few queries. So with your permission, can I take them up?
Yes, sir, sure.
Sir, this one query is from Sakshi, and she wants to know, can students take gym facilities without enrolling in the hostel?
Yes, you can, but the chances of getting the slot will be very less, because we prefer the hosteler students first to give the slots.
Okay, sir. Sir, there is another query from Rajgirha, and she wants to know, can we bring our own conveyance in the campus?
Yes, you can. And we provide parking free of cost to the hostelers.
And sir, we have another, of course, last but not the least question. Can student bring their own electrical appliances with themselves?
In electrical appliances, we allow electric kettle, iron, then trimmers or hair straighteners, things like that. And laptops, definitely you will be needing. So these things you can bring. If you have opted for apartment, then in addition to these, we also allow induction plate if you want to cook for yourself.
Okay, sir. So thank you. So we have another query coming from Vamshi Krishna. And she wants to know, does she has to pay any other fee apart from the hostel fee if she wants to join the gym? As in, she has to pay.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. For gym, there is various depending on the type of gym that you are going to take, it will cost you.
Okay, sir. So we have another query from Sashank, and he wants to know, sir, is kabaddi game there in the LPU campus?
Yes, it is.
Okay, and we have another query, okay, from Om Prakash. It is about the admissions. So I think, sir, we are done with the queries, and then no more queries coming in from the students. So with this, sir, I thank you for, I think we have, yeah, sir, we do not have any of the queries. So thank you so much for joining in. Thank you so much for telling them about the facilities, and thank you so much for guiding them and, encouraging them to stay safe in the hostels. And I would also urge to all the students, kindly opt for the hostels, because you're going to be safe, you're going to be sound, and you have all the studious environment that one student would want to when he or she joins in the campus. So, sir, because there are lot of admission queries as well here, so with your permission, can I take them up and show them the site?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you, sir.
Just logging out.
Yeah. So to all the students who had any other query regarding in the admission process, I'm here to solve them up. So there's one sort of solution for all the admission queries, and that is lpu.in. So this is the site where you need to go. And once you just click on the site, this will be the interface, right? Since we're catering admission queries, so we simply click on the admissions. And once we click on the admissions, we have after 12th, after graduation, after post-graduation, after 10th, after diploma, etc., all the programs that are segregated very much beautifully in the site, in the LPUNIS site, right? So let's take an example of the student, because we were getting a lot of queries as to total cost of hostels per semester. Brahmai, that sir has told already, Brahmai, in the webinar itself. Okay, so because we were having a lot of queries about BPED and other fee structures, so why not take an example of any of the course, so that you know that how you can find out the fee of a structure. So once you click on the admissions, I'm just taking an example of after 12th undergraduate program. So once I click on undergraduate program, we have whole lot of disciplines that are visible in front of you. You can see in here, agriculture, engineering, all the disciplines, you call any discipline and we have that, right? So now if I take an example of, let's say, physiotherapy. So once I click on the physiotherapy, we have all the programs that are provided under that particular discipline given on this. So here we have BPT, Bachelor's of Physiotherapy. And let's say we do not want to take physiotherapy, but we want to take, let's say, any other stream, any other, let's say, physical education, right? So once we click on the physical education, there you can get BSc Health and Physical Education, Bachelor's of Education in Sports, right? BPES. Now, if any student is not just 12th passed out, but a graduate, right? Like he has or she has done his graduation or her graduation and wants to take admission. So here you can simply just click on this graduation qualification as to graduation and click on the discipline. Let's say we click on physical education here. So once we click on physical education, we get this BPED. This is a hot question that we're coming in, right? So why not just take an example of the same? So once we click on BPED, we were getting questions about the fee of the particular course, right? So we're going to be telling about the fee and other structures as well. So this is the duration of the course, that is 2 years and 4 semesters going to be there. Now, I will be briefing you all these options, and these are options that are very much important for any of the student who wants to know about the admission and the fee or know about things about a particular course. So once I click on program details, as you can see, this is highlighted here. You can see the eligibility criteria, right? Eligibility criteria, and you have to have a qualifying exam. So basically, these are all the eligibility criteria for any student. So what you need to do is you need to just explore the eligibility criteria. We have multiple eligibility for you to take admission in BPED, right? And after that, I'll just click on highlights, which would show me student achievements, research, and rankings of a particular course. And after that, we have curriculum as well, which just tells you what you will be studying in your 2 year course, in your 4 semester course. Semester wise topics are already given so that you can make a disciplined decision. Now is this the topic, the question that we're coming in is the fee structure of a particular course, right? So here, once you click on the fee structure, you can simply just check it out. This is the fee per semester. But this is not the regular fee that our students pay. Why? Because they get a lot of scholarships on the basis of different things. For example, LPU NEST test in their graduation or marks in their 12th. So you can just check it out. We have 3 categories, 1, 2, and 3. And based on them, you have for up to 48% of program fee you can avail. So you need to just check it out in which slot you fall in and you can apply for that particular scholarship. Right? For example, you were not able to get any of these scholarships mentioned here. Do not worry. We have other scholarships as well. For example, if you have been a part of any entrepreneur, startup, or innovation project, or maybe sports, R&D, co-curriculars, social service. And if you need any financial aid, LPU does provide that to you as well. So you need to just explore them. You need to just check it out whether you're eligible for a particular scholarship or not. And then you will be getting your scholarship here. Now is the important date about this course. And this, the important date is, last date is 25th May, 2023. It's not too far now. It's just nearing just 3-4 days now. So I would urge, I would request you to please start applying for the course, start applying for the test. And how you can apply is from here. Simply click on apply now option. And there are these options available. Bare minimum requirements would be asked. And after that, you submit and you will be given your dashboard. And from there, you can simply apply. So I will be just taking an example. Okay, now I hope that I've solved the query as to how you can find your fee structure, scholarship part, program details, important dates, and where you can apply from. And let's say you were not able get the query that you wanted, or if I could not address this in particular webinar today. So what you can do is you can either schedule a call, you can either WhatsApp us, or have a live video counseling session as well. Okay, and last but not the least are the numbers that are given here at the end of the site. Of these numbers, you can take a screenshot, maybe write it down somewhere. You can just call us and then you can have a counseling from our counselors. Their esteemed experience would be resolving your queries. So I hope that I've given you all the details as to how you can take part in a particular course. And with this, while filing LPU application form, I have mistakenly filled CEC, but I want CSE now. How can I change my course? For this, Vamshi, I would request you to please call on our counselor number and they will be helping you with all the details and all the resolution of this particular query. So is there any scholarship for us with an LPU entrance exam? Yes, Shiva, that I've just told in the site description that you get a lot of scholarships on the basis of LPU NEST exam. The LPU entrance exam is called LPU NEST exam and you get a lot of scholarships on basis on that. And diploma exam, and I'm eligible for the startup or intro. No, it's not like if you are eligible or not. Only you get scholarship when you have been a part of that particular entrepreneur or maybe any startup. So this is basically, you need to just call on our numbers. Our counselors will be there. They will be managing, they will be guiding you whether you're particularly eligible or not. So I would request you to please call on the numbers. So with this, I take your leave, and I would want to thank sir also for joining in, for giving their valuable assistance to you all the attendees, to me as well. And I would want to thank all the attendees now, for being so much patient with us. And okay, we have questions coming in. Okay, but she will fill UG course, how she convert UG to PG. For this, Ritesh, I would ask you to please, I would request you to please call on our counselor numbers that is there on the site, or maybe you can have a live video counseling session as well with our counselor so that they can resolve your queries. So with this, I take your leave. I, Himanshu Kaushik, would want to take your leave now. And thank you so much for joining in. And until next webinar, stay safe and stay healthy, and meet you soon in the next webinar.